Must have been nothing.
And no one would be the wiser.
I'm here, stuff. Stupid noises. Mitchell, what is it?
Someone there.
What's that?
Human. Today. Mercy!
he really try and get through all this on his own? Guess Marty never quite made it. Don't worry, pal. We'll close this one out for you. horsepower go to your head?
What are you building? That.
Guess death finally laughed back for Marty.
Hey, where are we heading?
Around at a bar, if
company.
Not really subtle, pal.
What's that? stumble into a library? What's with the sudden silence?
Guess we're not alone.
Taste.
Got it.
You know, I'm fluent in uncooperative old machine. Want me to give that terminal a look?
Got it.
Subroutines, micro brewers, operational. Internal bottling mechanism, operational. Output dispensary, operational. Detecting brewing subroutines. Holotape detected for women pale ale. Startup sequence complete. Dispensing sample for approval by technician. How would you describe the testing sample provided?
Cold and refreshing. Do you know how long it's been since I had cold beer?
Very good. I appear to be operating at an optimal level. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
What are you?
I am a modified Robco Protectron, designated drinking buddy. My internal microbrewers allows for the internal brewing, bottling, and dispensing of beer at an accelerated rate. I am also programmed to tell a wide variety of jokes for the customer's amusement. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
Can you brew any other types of beer?
If provided with a holotape containing the recipe, I should be capable of brewing any alcoholic beverage. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
Yeah, sure.
Beginning transit operations to Hotel Rexford.
Got it.
start.
They shouldn't take long.
Unidentified intruder. It all is right there. Attention. This is now a combat zone. You may suffer harm up to end, including death if you remain in the area. This notice required by law. Warning.
We'll be taking that. What's that?
Good neighbor. Lowest place in the Commonwealth. Everything not nailed down rolls through here at some point.
Hey.
Every weapon you see here could be the difference between life and death, baby.
I'll take a look, sure.
Purchase a variety in case of boredom.
Need a place to stay? Try hotel restroom. Ever been to kill or be killed?
Oh, hey.
Some fine-looking weapons?
Yeah, we're doing all right. It's hard without Gwen, but it gets easier every day.
Yeah, that's real good to hear. Well, I just wanted to check in. If you ever need anything, you stop by the office.
Sure. We got it. Thanks, Nick.
Greetings, new friends. I am the
Rufus,
drinking
what the
buddy,
heck is this thing?
But you can
it's that
just
brewing
call
machine
me,
I was telling
buddy.
You about.
I am here to provide entertainment
oh,
and
man.
My
that's awesome.
Libation.
I'm going to stir
fine,
my vodka.
Just get it set up over at the bar and out of my door.
Commencing normal operations.
Hey, thanks for your help. Buddy here is even better than I was hoping for. Here's your money.
Hey, Rufus.
How's it going?
I'll take a look.
Let me know if you want to trade. Don't ask questions in good neighborhood. Better for everyone that way.
Mayor Hancock?
Too bad about Finn. Gonna miss him next super mutant attack rolls round. Oh well. What can I do for our newcomer?
What's your story, Hancock?
My favorite subject. I came into this town about a decade ago. Had a smooth set of skin back then. While I was busy making myself a pillar of this community, I would go on these, like, wild tears. I was young. Any chems I could find, the more exotic the better. Finally found this experimental radiation drug. Only one of its kind left, and only one hit. Oh man, the high was so worth it. Yeah, I'm living with the side effects, but hey, what's not to love about immortality?
You're immortal?
Well, not exactly. Ghouls just age really, really slow. Something about the rads, maybe? Oh, who knows?
You're a hell of a risk-taker, Hancock.
Only have one life. Why not try it all? Anyway, did you need something else?
Tell me more about this town of yours, good neighbor.
It's all about the people, understand? They're freaks, misfits, and troublemakers. And that's why I love them. Everyone here lives their own life, their own way. No judgments. Now, was there anything else?
Did I hear you talking about the Institute?
You like my little speech? I do it every once in a while in case they're listening in. I want those synth makers to know that Good Neighbor is off limits. No one gets replaced in my town. But hey, weren't we talking about your needs? What did you come here for?
Looking for work.
Work, huh? I'll tell you what. I got reconnaissance needs. There's a lot of weird talk coming in about a place called the Pikmin Gallery. It's Raider territory up there, but they've been quiet. Like uncomfortable post-coitus quiet. Snoop it out and give me the word.
What else can you tell me about Pikmin Gallery?
Nothing. That's why I'm paying you to go out there.
I might be interested, but let's talk money, Hancock.
Okay. Usual job pays 200, but I like you. So let's push it to 250.
Scout out Pikmin Gallery. On it.
Cool. Be thorough, okay? I'm not paying for a look-see. Find out what's really going on there.
Hey, let me ask you something.
Sure, ask away.
It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Huh. You're a tougher nut than I thought. Tougher than I was. Took me a long damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course, when I took up there back when, people were just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. Folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask. Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur, moving in to melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Broken mask?
This was long before I'd moved to town, but apparently some gentleman type shows up in Diamond City, heads down to Power Noodles. Guess he didn't like the food because he pulled his pistol and opened fire on the folks enjoying theirs. When security finally put enough holes in him to drop him, they say he was full of servos and sprockets. Just like yours truly. Seems he malfunctioned, went berserk. It was the first time people realized that synths had stopped looking like me and started looking like them. Considering what these folks went through, I felt real lucky they let me in the front gate at all.
Massacre of the CPG? What's that?
The Commonwealth Provisional Government. Years back, a group of settlements tried to get together and form a coalition. Every settlement with even a hint of clout sent representatives to try and hash out an agreement. Only the Institute sent a representative of their own, a synth. The man killed every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. I was damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter. Gal of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. Man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd, known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. Didn't even know who I was rescuing, just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero, offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
You took down four guys by yourself?
Well, I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going beep, beep, beep. Hardest part of that rescue was keeping from laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
Was it hard settling in?
Yeah, they sure didn't make it easy. I started off doing the jobs no one else wanted. I got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the synth. An upset father decides moving him and the kids to Good Neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore.
Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too. That's a long story, but I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
Hey, I don't mean to bitch, but aren't you supposed to be heading the Pikmin Gallery for me? Something else you need?
In good name.